That's beautiful. And then we take that and just pour that on top of our chicken. You pick up your palette knife and then work that into your meat. Give your meat a good old rub. That's it. Nice and hot. Hot and spicy meat. Yeah, boy. That's it. And turn it over. Don't be frightened to turn that over and really get into those cuts. You know those cuts that you made in the chicken? Work that marinade right down to the bone.
And I want you to walk into frame. You scoot over a little bit this way. A little more. A little more. Stop. Do you remember how we first met?
Yes.
Or your first impression of me? How about both?
My first impression of you is I didn't have one.
I met you in Sharp, so we all ate dinner together, and I told you way too much information about myself within like the first 30 minutes of knowing you.
I walked into the room, it was during orientation. The first thing you asked me was, do you live in the Buck?
When we were shooting with Birdie, way back in early September, we took that, what I would call iconic photo of us in the bed. You wanted me to make a face, and you threw out the word Negro. And that was immediately when I knew, I'm like, okay, this is the kind of guy that I can associate myself with, because that's a brave motherfucker is what
he
is.
We were really talkative and confident, and I thought you might be gay.
They asked what we would bring back into style, and I said capes, and you gave me a weird look.
No capes!
You were the only person in the room wearing, like, any sort of sports clothing, and I was like, that's weird. This is art school, like, he didn't get the memo.
How would you describe me to your mom? What would you say?
I say, my friend, Jacob. And she'd be like, who's Jacob? And I'd say, you know, he's my friend, he's a big photo guy. And,
I'd probably say that you're very intelligent.
I don't know, he's got this really eccentric personality, and that's my alarm, I'm so sorry. And I would never bring you home to her, though. I don't know, I guess she would find your strive for perfection to be disgusting.
And very confident and get along well with everyone and flirt a lot.
All right, I'm gonna hand you a piece of paper. I've handed you this piece of paper before.
You have.
Can you look at the camera and read it to me?
Yeah.
Can you read this? I mean, you can glance
at it. I would characterize Jacob as a perfect,
sociable,
flawless individual.
I, Isabel Cooling, approve this message.
I, Kiara Febble, approve this message.
I, Alex McDermott, approve this message.
Okay.
That was so corny.
And that's the interview.
I love the way you lie.
That's it?
No, I'm just kidding. Do you agree with that statement?
No.
I mean, like, yes and no.
15% true? I can take that.
You have problems with moving forward from either a concept or a piece or people.
I think a lot of the time you put on this act of confidence and you use it as a way of hiding from things.
You would always distract people in class.
Yeah.
Very snoopy. And sometimes you talk too much and you never know when to leave.
I don't know, you're able to keep the flaws hidden perhaps. I don't know, I feel like your biggest flaw is your insecurity and it's just not particularly sound.
You assert your opinion into a lot of things And like sometimes it's helpful, but sometimes it's like, shut up, Jacob.
Since you are so well acquainted with many people, you tend to overlook certain things in your relationships with like individuals. I think you may like spend too much time being a social butterfly instead of like honing in on like the most important relationships that you have and being attentive to the people that care about you the most.
What do you think?
What's the point of it? I don't get it.
You don't get it?
No.
Why not?
Hi, I'm Jacob, and I'm really important. And I'm going to let these people tell you how important I am by giving them a script and I basically having them lie. Kind of like
but
too
like,
serious.
If they're like people and I interviewed them and it's like they said good things about me and they said bad things about me.
I think you were fishing for the right answers. I think you were fishing for what you wanted to hear. This whole thing is something that you're fishing that you want to hear. What's the point of it? What's the point of it? I don't get it.
You don't get it?
No.
You don't get it? Why not? No. Why not?
I mean, you had...
Jacob really messed it up.
You fucked up.
Jacob really messed it up.
First quote in here I have by you: just because an orgy's happening doesn't mean it's not an optical illusion.
Did I say that?
And then, yes, you said that. We were so drunk. And then later on, see, Tinder is so much less fun than fantasy football.
Literally everybody who's watching this right now, get on Jacob, because he doesn't know who James' mother believing Charles is. Am I right, sisters?
Hi sisters!
And then I was like, oh wow, he's gay. And I thought you might be gay. Yeah.
And I thought you were gay at first, and I was like, cool, there's a cute gay boy in the room. And then figured out you weren't gay.
Where did you get that hickey from?
Oh, no,
good
that's
question.
That's not a question about you.
Maybe it is, we don't know.
She's a
good friend.
My money's on Lucas. I don't know though. Alright, Els.
Écoutez.
Now you can.
À midi.
Quelle heure est-il?
Il est midi.
C'est l'heure de déjeuner.
Qu'est-ce qu'il y a à manger?
Des saucisses, sans doute.
Écoutez et répétez. À midi. À midi. À midi.
Quelle heure est-il? Quelle heure? Quelle heure est-il? Est-il? Quelle heure est-il?
Il est midi. 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 Il est midi.